Hello, in this video, we will see the VisualARQ section attributes that can be used on VisualARQ objects, but also on Rhino geometry, in order to show their sectioned area with a specific line weights and hatch patterns. For example, when we activate any of these section lines, we can see already that VisualARQ objects, some of them, have specific attributes, such as this hatch pattern. So for VisualARQ objects, we can assign those attributes from the styles dialog, but also from the properties panel. For example, if we select this stair, we go to the properties panel, and from this icon, we can find here the different section attributes that we can assign to the sectioned area of that object. For example, print width, print color, or hatch pattern, for example, solid one. In the case of VisualArq objects, we can do this from the styles dialog. For example, I can select this stair again, go to the properties, click on more, and select the style properties. Now, if I select, for example, the stair slab, I can find here the same attributes that they had in the properties panel. So now I can assign a different hatch pattern to that object, for example, a single one. Assign the same scale and rotation as the slabs and walls. Now, the attributes defined by style will override any of these attributes assigned directly to the object. In the case of Rhino geometry, the only way to assign section attributes is from the properties panel. Imagine that we had some Rhino geometry, for example, a big box that represents soil. I'm gonna move this down 10 centimeters. When I activate one of this VisualArq section lines, now we can select that object, and from the properties panel, assign any of these attributes. For example, this hatch pattern. Also here, it is interesting to see the clipping status. When this is activated, this object will be clipped by VisualArq sections or levels. But when it's off, it will ignore sections and levels.